So when Carol talked about how drone strikes killed fewer than other war, killed fewer people than other wars, that doesn't really, that's not really true, because the US always seems to mistake civilians as militants. For example, in the NBC News investigations, about one of every four of those killed by drones in Pakistan between, about one in every four of those killed by drones in Pakistan between September 3rd, 2010 to October 30th, 2011 were classified as other militants. And how the CIA could not determine the affiliation of those killed, prompting the questions about how the agency could conclude they were a threat to US national security. And in regards to the assassination attempt on the Queen, as Carol stated, as those people were actually foreigners, a stricter visa policy would have also prevented that assassination attempt, which would make that point moot. In regards to the fear of attacks, we also have manned attacks. We have SEAL teams, and such as SEAL Team 6, who assassinated the Al-Qaeda leader, and how, if they don't fear those people, then that's just, and she also states how people, without drones, terrorists can train more people. However, she also states that it's easy to spot training grounds. And so if that's the case, then conventional means should also be adequate enough for an attack. And she talks about how soldiers are also at risk if we remove drone strikes. However, we also have to think about dehumanization of war that also comes with that. As said by Justin Sink from thehill.com, it's a trend to dehumanize warfare. It's machines and computers doing the job. In his interview with the California representative, William Woolsey, she says that, Candy, this is not video games. These are real people, and it's real death that we're making real enemies around the world by continuing with drone strikes, as she said on the State of the Nation. And in regards to her comments about the post-traumatic stress disorder, she fails to take into account other sorts of mental health deficiencies as well. And according to the Armed Forces Health Surveillance Center and their monthly service report, approximately 8.2% of RPA pilots had at least one mental health outcome, which includes adjustment disorder, alcohol abuse, depressive disorder, PTSD, among others. And as well as, and she talks about how drone strikes are efficiently able to kill leaders. However, according to CNN, that's not the case, as since it began in 2004, the drone campaign has killed 49 militant leaders whose deaths have been confirmed by at least two credible news sources. While this represents a significant blow to the militant chain of command, these 49 deaths account for only 2% of all drone-related fatalities. And as such, that's not the case.